Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In this episode, we will tackle a problem that I'm sure you have stumbled upon in your own code base numerous times, namely how to go from an enum value to a string in a serialization method, for example. I'll bet you that you have code in your own code base that looks pretty much like this. And that was just for the going from the enum to the string. You likely also have code that looks like this. Going back again. In this episode today, I'll show you a small trick how to avoid that boilerplate code. So let's just revisit the code once again. We have an enum here, an enum class, ExampleEnum. It has the values foobar and baths, and I have my method for going from the enum to a string. If the enum value is foo, return the string foo. If it's bar, return string bar, and so on. And similar down here, I have the code from going from the string, namely foo, onto the example enum's foo value here. And this code is what you'll very likely find in lots of different places where you're serializing some data structure onto a file and back again. But it is annoying writing this, and I'll bet you that over the years you have tried with different kinds of hash define for solving this problem. But there is a much more beautiful way in Qt. If you have ever used QML, you'll know that it's possible to export enums from a C++ layer to the QML layer. But wait a minute, QML is just a regular text file that is read at runtime, so how is that mapping possible? Or if you use Qt Designer, you'll notice that in the configuration sidebar of Qt Designer, you can actually customize properties that are enums with their string value, not just with the numbers 0, 1, 2, and 3. So how is that possible? The answer is simple. There is mapping inside of Qt that does this for you. And let me just find this class here for you, QMetaEnum. QMetaEnum is the class inside Qt that makes it possible to map from the string to the enum value and back again. And if you look at it, the first thing we want to do, of course, is how do I get my hands on such a QMetaEnum object? And you do that using this static method down here, static public method. It's slightly annoying that you cannot see that it's templarized from this overview, but if I click on it, you'll see that it's actually templarized on the enum type. So with that, you can go get to that object, and then you can use this keys to value. It takes a const pointer and returns an integer. And we have the value to key that takes the integer and return the const pointer. And of course, the integer is the integer value of that enum. And the const pointer is the actual string representation. Do you mind stopping here for a second, Jesper? A pointer, this is not like 2000, it is 2021. What on earth? Well, it might be that you have something that you want to do with this that does not necessarily map into a QString. And given that the QMetaEnum is really, really at a low level of the Qt stack, I guess it's okay that it's a char pointer and not a QString. Trust me, everything in Qt these days is UTF-8. So this char pointer can be mapped straight into a QString with just a regular QString from UTF-8 method. And this brings us to the actual code this time. So I have a class here. It's a subclass of QObject. It will be obvious in a second why. The class has the enum class ExampleEnum here with foobar and baths. It marks up this using Q_enum. So ExampleEnum here is marked up with Q_enum. And did I mention it has Q_object up there? The reason for Q_object, the Q_enum, and the QObject superclass is that its mock, our little friend that is executed on our header files, it is that one that spits out code for this mapping. So in the mock generator file, you'll actually be able, not directly, but somewhat easily, to see the value from the enum onto the string and back again. And then I've implemented a little helper class called enum helper here that has a method toString. The toString method takes the enum, returns the string representation of it. The from string method takes the string, and this time I need to explicitly tell it which enum here, and then it returns that enum, and I can print that out using QString also, or you're using QDebug also. Let me show you what the enum helper class looks like. It's over here. So it's pretty simple. There isn't all that much to it. So let's start with the QString down here. That seems to be the shorter version. So the toString takes my enum value, casts that to an integer. So my enums underneath the hood is, of course, integers or similar types. So I'll cast it to an integer. I have an int value here, and then I go to my qmeter enum from type. That was the method for looking up this, an instance of this qmeter enum class. So from this type that I've given here as a templarized method or templarized type here, I now have qmeter enum from type this thingy here. That is an object of the type qmeter enum. It calls this method value to key, taking the integer here, and returns a qstring as we want. The other way around is similar, easy. Again, it's a temporized method on the enum type. It goes from that string to that enum type here. And again, look up. No, that was too much. Here, look up the actual qmeter enum for that one, and then simply call key to value. With that text that came in here, it needed a char pointer or const char pointer, so I need to take that and convert, take my text and convert that to that representation using the 2UTF-8. It also has this ampersand OK here that will contain, was it even possible? It might have been that I just gave it a wrong string or some such. So if it's OK, or if it's not okay, I'll print out, hey, I couldn't convert it, and I'll return parentheses open, parentheses close, which is, or brace, whatever you call them, which is the C++ 11 version of just a default constructed value of that type over here. So that's because I need to return such a type. And finally, if everything went okay, I'll return the converted value. You can take this here, basically just cut and paste it into your own code base, and now you can go and simply write enum helper toString and enum helper from string and print them out. Oh, Jesper, please stop again. Why do you actually need to go from the enum onto the string representation? Couldn't Qt do that internally now already? You're right, it could. Let me show you. So up here, we have let me just run the debug output here. You can see it print out new wave. That's what we have here, new wave, bar, foo, and then the failure notice here when I try to convert badam. And I print out here just the bar, and then I convert my enum, and I convert that back again. And of course, I convert it back again, so I can show you that that is possible. But I could also do it like this and just print out my enum. And let's run that, compiling. And once it's compiled, you can see that it actually new wave. Well, it printed out the complete string there. But now that we actually went through the trouble and added these Q underscore enum, Qt will actually know when you print them out using QDebug to print them out in a slightly more readable way, namely with a name rather than just number 3. So that was nice, wasn't it? No more writing all that boilerplate code. So thank you for... Oh yeah, you don't really like the fact that it's requiring you to be in a QObject subclass. You'd like your global enums to work this way. Let me show you how you can do that. So back here with the code, I have another way to specify my enums. Namely, instead of being a subclass of QObject, I can put them into a namespace. And then with Q5.8, if I'm not wrong, we got this Q underscore namespace macro here. It does the same thing for mock as Q underscore object does. Namely, extract information about everything in here so that we can use that in our infrastructure with Qt. And I have my enum here, and I wrap that back down there. And now I can again use my enum helper here, enum helper to string, our namespace example, enum colon colon bar. Don't give me that look. I know that you wanted a global one. Well, it isn't all that difficult to just end this whole shebang here with our namespace. Yes, yes. I didn't really intend to have a namespace. So therefore, I'm just starting it right away. See? Pretty nifty once again. Final question. How about if I have my enum in one of my value-based classes? Therefore, not inside a Q namespace already set up, not in a QObject subclass, what do I do then? And the answer is gadgets. Go, go, gadget arm. I don't know why I need to say that. Well, because I can never remember what it's called, but go, go, gadget arm. I can remember it's called a gadget, and now you'll never forget either. Well, you're welcome. So gadgets, I have a class here, my value class. I'll simply, instead of my Q underscore object, I'll add my Q underscore gadget. Here's my enum as before. Here is the declaration of my enum. I can even have my enum as whatever. And then I will be printing out, again, enum helper to string, my value colon bar. As always, the code is on our GitHub repository. The URL is in the text below. The code is licensed MIT, so you can simply take the enum helper namespace and put it into your own code and be done with all that boilerplate code for going from one side to the other side. I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and please let me advertise a bit for what we do. We do trainings, consulting, services, anything around Qt, C++, and OpenGL. So if you have any needs there, please do reach out to us. That is what makes it possible for me to get a salary, despite that I put out a free episode of Qt Widgets and more. Until next time, have a great day.